Welcome to Now We Know Tarot, Daily Encouragement and More, from the Gnosis Hostess with the Mostess. Only use what amuses. Today we're using the Rider-Waite Tarot and the Wheel of Fortune Tarot, along with other decks to be determined. What do we now know from the tarot today for our collective? First, we have the Page of Pentacles. Second, we have the High Priestess. And third, we have the Knight of Swords. What I see here is at the center of the reading, there is a focus of special spiritual energy. Both the Page and the Knight are looking toward this person who feels advanced in something. The Page of Pentacles is talking about an opportunity, and the Knight of Swords is taking rapid action. The High Priestess, although seated, has a lot going on behind the curtain that other people aren't aware of, but they are representing the higher spiritual principle and some sort of talent as well, I presume. Someone is going to parlay their imagination, intuition, and spiritual knowledge into something quite profitable. They're going to be sought after and monetize something here. Tell us a little bit more about this fabulous person who is not well known and unrecognized, but highly spiritual. Everybody wants some. The Page of Pentacles has the Ten of Wands, the Six of Cups, and the Queen of Cups. Okay, this person wasn't always so well-defined and rounded. They had a lot of burden in their life. Although they do have a sense of nostalgia for the past, they're all full of love and compassion for everyone. It feels like this opportunity is a long time coming. It will allow them the chance to drop burdens that are no longer needed and invite new happiness into their life. I feel like they will be well served in being financially remunerated. How are they feeling now, this High Priestess? Give us a few more crumbs or details about what's hidden behind the curtain, please, if you would. The Wheel of Fortune, it's their time. The Ten of Swords, they've suffered betrayal. And the Knight of Swords, they're highly nervous about any type of changes to their quiet life of solitude and knowledge. So even though they have a lot to share and things will go their way, any type of change might be perceived as turbulent for them. Tell us about the quick change of affairs coming into their life in this probability of the Knight of Swords, the Nine of Wands, the Tower, there it is, and the Lovers. The Lovers is connected to the Six of Cups card. It's someone from the past who they know and they've had casual yet good acquaintance with. This person pops up again toward the end of the reading. The Tower is the change that I talked about. But I feel like it will release them from both this Ten of Wands and Ten of Swords. And even though it will be a lot, they will be resilient with the Nine of Wands and move into a period of pleasure, connection, etc., etc. That is if they don't bolt, because underneath the deck, we have the Eight of Cups. The energy is coming toward them. The opportunity is being given to them. All they would have to do, if this is you, would be remain calm and centered, which might be a lot given the amount of stress you've been placed under by life. And also something about too much going on in your head or not getting enough sleep. Although the Nine of Swords is kind of remediated into the Nine of Wands, which I would say you need an outlet to express your frustration, which might be through your body and exercise. Because you're planning to go along with the changes. I mean, the Tower doesn't really give you all that much to work with, but when you get out the other side, you have the Lovers, which indicates you will be connected with this happy times again type of vibe, if it's not a particular person, okay? So let's get more in depth with a little sweary affirmation cards, because on this deck they have like a whirlwind. So tell us about the Tower. That's what I want to know about. There's a crescent moon here. It says, you don't have to be perfect to be effing awesome. Whatever new thing comes in, there's a learning curve, and you'll get the hang of it after a while. I want to know more about this Wheel of Fortune, because that's indicating a great change of fortune, right? It has on it someone waving a napkin. It's okay to lose touch with the people you used to be. You're doing some type of spiritual work that makes you the best version of yourself. And finally, tell us about the Six of Cups. I really want some more details. Seems juicy to me. There's a plant on here. It says, the most authentic growth happens as a result of the most uncomfortable S. Well, someone here is being wedged out of their comfort zone. But they're also updating themselves and inviting new versions of people, places, and things into their life as well, reconnecting. Let's look at the Effet Oracle cards for romance, because we have the Lovers here. Yes, you can work through the shitty challenges. The ugliest outhouse still gets the job done. Tell us about this Ten of Wands, the burden. Are your core values similar? Ask the hard effing questions and seek out the answers. You've changed, and so therefore you need people who are now at your new level. Tell us about this Ten of Swords, Nine of Swords energies. That's your transformational tension, I'll call it. F, happiness. Happiness isn't the goal. It is the result of getting through the stupid times without anger. Well, you're definitely holding it together because the High Priestess is not a drama queen. That's for sure. When will this transformation to the Lovers be completed? Let's look at the many faces of the moon. On Thursday, what will happen? How and when, please? One link in a chain of events breaks. It creates doubt over a successful outcome. When doubt never changed the world, and that's what you're here for. Your unique ability to stay focused on your goals leads you down a better path. The situation is quantitatively improving. When that tower comes in, when that rush of energy comes at you from this Knight of Swords, you're resilient toward it. You navigate the tower and you reconnect with something that's meant for you. It's a big yes. It will happen on a Thursday, maybe near a new moon. And as a result of you not letting people yank your chain and make you angry, you are going to be placed into an upgraded situation. For some of you, this would be like finding out your flight got canceled, but then you get a hotel and a first class upgrade. So if you can use that as a metaphor for your life, whatever doesn't happen is the blessing. And the silver lining is the compensation and the upgrade inside of you to something that's more correct, because it is a journey after all. Let's look at the Take a Magical Effing Journey card. One more card, I hope. Relax. Life is meant to be enjoyed, a reminder to take some chill pills and kick it. This is not something you can resist. This is not something you can plan for. This is not something that you can control. Although you'll remain centered and calm through it, there's some sort of event that will catapult you into a better life. And with this Wheel of Fortune card, and then with this skeleton resting on it like an inner tube, this is like reminding you, as your karma turns, as the days of your life progress, you didn't agree to be put into a storyline that was always where you needed to take your pulse to see if you were alive. If you feel dead inside, this is the reading that will resonate for you, because you are going to get kick-started into something fabulous and awesome. So even though you may feel bored, something's going to happen that takes you outside of your comfort zone and changes things forever, provided that you don't bolt from the experience. Remember, you're an expert at the Eight of Cups. Don't call a halt to it with the Judgment card. Just let it ride and ride with it, with this Ace of Pentacles. The Ace of Pentacles in the clarifier and the Ace of Pentacles at the beginning is your prompt to let you know that this process is starting. And it's going to continue no matter what you do. No matter what you do, you can't stop this from happening. You signed up for this, and it's your greatest coup, actually. Let's get an affirmation card for Women's Swery Edition to just kind of cheerlead you and champion you along. totally. You are great just the way you are, so keep the a-holes from dictating what you should be. You're still calling the shots, but you're riding the ride. And you're going to make it happen, keeping most of your core values intact. You're calm and a better life. This is your wish come true. It's a favor for you from the universe. So, as this card says, relax. And that is what we now know from the tarot today. Thank you and namaste effing day.